Pacer TV. Of course, we have Envious and Fnatic coming up on Train. That'll be the next map.
Yeah. That's a nice looking headset you got there.
Why, thank you.
Yeah. Where's it from?
Well, I think it's from Razer. This is the Razer Kraken. We have a 50% discount for all the Polish viewers. Hello, Poland. You can click on the Razer banner on the profile, the Twitch profile. Just scroll down a little bit and you get rid of our ugly faces and you can find yourself a banner to click. And if you are from Poland, you can get one of these.
Yeah.
Minus 15%.
It's a pretty good deal.
I like deals. But enough about that. We do have Envious and Fnatic coming from Train. And again, Fnatic, they got beasted last time I've seen them play Train. I don't know why, because the current meta really fits them. We not only saw them lose to Titan, we saw them lose to... it was against Titan, right?
Yes, yeah, it was.
Yeah. Also Envious.
Yeah.
Also beat them there. So I don't know what's going on with Fnatic right now. Do you, just generally, I want your general thoughts on Fnatic. Is there an issue going into this next major? Because they are looking kind of the weakest, kind of, maybe, for a long time.
I think this is the weakest we've seen Fnatic before a major.
Yes.
You know, in the Fnatic era, which has been for quite some time now. So probably quite few people are thinking this is the start of the beginning of the end, really. Kind of similar as to what it was for NIP, but people thought it was the beginning of the end for NIP, and then they won Cologne. So maybe Fnatic is just going to end up winning Collusion.
That's always the thing that I think about, right? Is the NIP thing. Because it's exactly the same. Where it's like, oh, you know, they're done. They're never going to win again. This is like last major for them. They're going to get knocked out. It's all going to suck.
Yeah.
It's like, well, they win. And even when they won, it looked like horrendous the entire way through.
Oh, it was like
every single game. It's like
eking out victories that they shouldn't have won. But in the end, they end up... I guess, to be fair to NIP in that Cologne finals, they played absolutely amazing in the finals.
Yeah.
That has to be said. But up to that point, it was just very wobbly.
So shaky.
Yeah, it wasn't pretty. But so maybe that's the route Fnatic are going for, you know, trying to find different ways to win. Who knows? But as of right now, their form going into the tournament is obviously not especially good. And I'm not really sure what the big thing is or what the
natural
big
maybe it's like a just natural peak and trough.
Yeah, definitely could be.
Downswing at the moment.
And I think the Fnatic players are one of the teams who have been better than other teams at being selective about what tournaments they go to and what they compete in so they don't get burnt out. And maybe that's what they've been going through. They've been ever so slightly burnt out because they've had a lot to do, a lot of tournaments to attend as of late, or maybe they haven't reached their final form. They're just lurking in the shadows until the majors. Because I don't think it's completely strange to see. There's definitely a correlation between the weird results we're seeing, you know, in the games leading up to the major, because the major is so close.
Yeah.
So you're gonna have teams. Maybe it's not like they're not trying, but they're not gonna pull out anything extra. They're just gonna do what they've been doing for the last couple of months, and that's gonna be what they rely on. If that doesn't work, then
there's this thing, isn't there? Where it's essentially no matter how much you can tell yourself this is an important match, this is an important situation, sometimes you need these spots. Again, there are natural peaks and troughs. There's natural ups and downs because your brain, like, you know that it's important, but like you're just not in the right, you're not in the right feeling, the right emotional state to really give it everything. Yeah, it's just for some reason you need that loss. You need to get reminded that this is important to you, and that happens. That's a natural thing that all players go through. So
and
it could be a bit of a slump.
Yeah, and I think it's easier if you're a new team to take everything more seriously. Simply because it's a new environment, you're super excited about everything you do. For Fnatic, who've been so dominant for so long, it's more they
proven
know
it
where
already,
exactly, and they know where the real honor lies, and that's winning offline tournaments. So when they get to these games, it's more like, oh, let's get through it. And if it goes badly, they're gonna be pissed because obviously they want to win. They're competitive beings, so they're gonna be pissed about it. But it's not something that they're just gonna completely make them implode. So you know, to make the very long story short, I think Fnatic, you don't have to worry about them going into the major. But Envy, you know, likewise to Fnatic, they've had some up and downs results as well. You know, after doing so well as of late.
Yeah, 100% pistol win last season on this map. That's pretty scary. Let's see if they can continue said form. Looking to make their way into the inner bomb side at the moment.
Flash is holding not by himself this time. When we saw them play Titan, Fletcher was a lot of times all by himself on B.
That flank there from JW, he is on a big mission of discovery.
Well, Olafmeister goes down, but the rotation has already happened for Fnatic here. Krim's picking up a kill onto Keo. Bomb's going to go down for Envy, though, so that's a lot of money secured. And the flank from JW is actually going to get flanked by Happy.
Yeah, that's a really big deal. But the players of Envy are rather low on the HP, and Flasher and Krim's are there as well to try to rush the train yacht and get themselves the finishing blows. There is the first kill. Krim's will take down MBK.
Krim's
will
also find
Kenny, yes. So Happy's got a lot of work to do. He's got to take this frag. This has to go his way, but he's going to go for the reload. And, oh, Crimson's off the... Oh, no, Crimson's off the defuse. Is there even time to run there? I don't think that there is. Flash is going to have to get out of there or try, and the round will be won by Envious. So another pistol round victory for them. And we're going to have a situation where Fnatic will have... This is actually what ruined them in the past when they got 16-3'd, was the fact that they lost the pistol round on the CT side, and then they had like two chances. Like, you get two or three chances to win buy versus buy, and if you don't win those, you're just done.
Yeah.
You're done.
Especially being on the CT side, because it's so expensive, so you're only going to get that one chance. Eventually on the T side, you're always going to have two rounds in a row where you're able to buy, and that way break the economy of the CTs, depending on how you do, potentially earlier. Well, as CT, you don't really get that luxury. So you have to make it count once you get the chance. Well, they're forcing up. Pronex not buying armor. This is always weird to me. Like, when you have a force buy like this, why is there... Oftentimes you see one guy who doesn't buy anything at all. And it's not like Pronex is saving to pick up an op. But I guess it could actually be the situation where he's saving up an op for one of his teammates.
Oops.
Bit of a similar nade right there from MBK.
Oh, we got a close JW there with the CZ. He won't get much done there with the CZ, though. And now Envious know that he's there. Be far in a little bit. Apex will get the kill. He's down quite low, though, 4 HP. So you could argue that the damage has been done there by JW.
Pronex going to finish off Happy, so that's a big kill as well. He's also going to get an AK to work with. Krims finishes off MBK after all that damage JW did. And I'm super surprised by the fact that Envy didn't push out on JW, because they knew he'd used all his bullets on the CZ the first time around, so they could have gotten an easy kill with no damage taken. Instead, MBK goes down, and Apex is now on 4 HP.
Yeah, here we go. Bomb planted for Envious. But with the HP as low as it is, and Pronex on the AK, this might not go the way of Envious here. They're in trouble. The Flusher goes just spraying the mag. It does get a little bit of damage onto Kiyoshima, but here he goes now around the side as these Envious players are just waiting with bated breath. And Krims, oh, good game sense there to look down to see that the smoke was being traversed through by Kiyoshima. And it's just Apex left. He'll go down to Fronax. So four players surviving. That's a massive result there from Fnatic. Back into this one straight away. That's so important.
That's huge for Fnatic. And, well, they're already going to avoid that trap they fell into the last time they played Envy. So that has to be a sigh of relief for them. I still think the cardinal error of that round is Envy not being aggressive enough, or basically being too scared to punish JW after pushing out, letting him reload and do so much damage onto MBK and Apex and Ally, because that more or less makes them not as useful. You can't send people with low HP out first to try to find a peek.
Oh yeah. And they have two MAC-10s saved as well, so that's a lot of money potentially. But the force buy comes in from Envious as a response, and two quick frags will leave Fnatic in a complete state of despair. And it's just Flusher and Krims remain now. MBK close to the train, finds a nice shot there onto Krims. And now Flusher, he's got to kill four players with that AK-47 of his. And it looks like Envious have actually turned the situation around massively. They now picked up their weapons.
Maybe this was the plan all along.
This is actually just, this is so weird. This is really horrible for Fnatic.
Yeah.
Oh my god, what a situation.
Well, I guess luckily for them, seeing how they want to eco on their own, they only have to do one eco at this point, and they're going to be able to buy up and actually get a pretty good buy. You can see Flush and Krim sitting on 4.4 and 4.1. So there's going to be money there, but... Oh, actually, Flush decides to buy up a Colt. Okay.
I guess they forced it up.
Yeah, this is...
Completely, almost.
Well, Krims still has 3.9.
That doesn't make
200
any
bucks.
Sense.
No, it's... Oh, yeah, it's got a 5. No, yeah, this... Then we saw a super weird buy from Fnatic yesterday as well, when they just randomly...
Found a T-side.
Yeah. Started to buy MP7s and whatnot. And this is... It's really strange. Obviously, Fnatic, they want to break the economy of Envy, but if they don't win this round, they're... really toying with just the general health of their CT side.
And Envious, of course, are taking their time, their sweet time on this one. Trying to make sure that if Fnatic are going to make a mistake, that they can punish.
Yeah.
And that's what it's all about, getting the punishers in.
And they don't want to make the same mistake they did in the previous round with in Alley. So right now, just going as a group and, yeah, capitalizing on every mistake that Fnatic makes, but also making sure that you don't do silly things. Well, if you're going to get down on side, bomb's still trapped on higher, but MVK's taking down Flusha, and that's going to allow him to drop the bomb down. And this should be a fairly easy Fnatic round with Flusha, only guy who got a proper weapon, actually. With him going down, Ulfmeister being the sole member alive for Fnatic. It's not really a lot they can do. But now, all in all, just a super weird buy from Fnatic. I cannot understand what prompted them to do that. Because that doesn't make sense on any level, especially when Cribs doesn't decide to buy up as well.
Yeah, that's the weird thing, is that, okay, sure, you decide to buy, but why isn't Grimms buying? Why is he stuck on 3900? Because
if they do something like a drop an op now for Ulfmeister and then the rest of them force buy, I'm even more baffled. Because that just seems like faulty logic to me. That just doesn't make sense in my book. But then again, it would be super typical if they won that round because of it. So.
Oh, well, here we go. Crimson's got that $5,800. He's probably wondering what to do. That he could drop pistols to his teammates.
Yeah.
Or he could buy a 5.7 and a smoke. And he bought, what did he buy? He bought another pistol, I think. I think he dropped something for teammates.
He bought a P250 for Flusha, I think. Well, Kenny's gonna make work with that op that he has picked up. And, well, not investing a lot into this round. Probably hoping to at this point, find Kenny and get that op out of his hands. But that's gonna be hard to do.
The flying stickers, man.
They're back.
Flying stickers.
That's how you know the major is here.
Yeah, just the flying stickers all over the place. Now we're gonna get a situation here where Envious have another clean round, four players surviving, I think, three times in a row. So that's really, really nice for them. And the situation for Fnatic, of course, Crims has a lot of money. They can buy finally now. But Crims is, I guess, just gonna keep some bank, I guess. So it seems like there wasn't ever really a plan for that money necessarily. It's sitting there still, but let's see what that's
saving it for a rainy day.
Yeah, so let's see where that actually ends up going later on. But now we have a situation for Fnatic where they really need to get the ball rolling. They need to get the round win. And what are Envious going to do to try to prevent that? Looks like a quick push came in from Fnatic that Envious are able to trade evenly with, which is going to be good. And they're going to spring onto the B-bomb side off the back of that pick and get themselves a plant straight away. Kenny's looking for the shots there on the cross, but smoke goes down there to get CTs out of connector. And this is actually a bad situation for Envious. Usually, you know, you would expect the CTs to have a good way to attack the bomb site, but we'll have to see them if they can execute these frags. MBK's up in the train yard there. He's doing a good job, actually, taking these CTs down. Kiyoshima in with the AWP. 2v1 now. Crim's close to the bomb site. Got Kiyoshima and Happy left alive. The Molotov and Happy, that's why he's going to this position, and Crims is actually predicting it wonderfully. 19 HP left on him though, but that won't matter too much because Kiyoshima has the AWP, but that bomb is ticking very quickly at this point. It's all over for Kiyoshima. It's all over for Fnatic's chances to win this round, and Kiyoshima might barely be able to survive this. Indeed he will, and Envious will win another round.
Extremely aggressive play from Flusha right there. Supremely, it's kind of strange, actually.
Yeah, we had a lot of train-based crashes yesterday as well.
Yeah.
So
what can you do?
Yeah, so that's a new thing, I think, as well. It's pretty new thing. So, let's see if that gets fixed. I mean, lots of bugs in the game. We saw the stickers just flying around in your face. Just
basically around. Covering up the entire screen.
Yeah.
How amazing, or you know, how horrible for the players would it be? But if that actually happened.
Yeah, that would suck.
That would be like, guys, I can't buy the op anymore. I've got four stickers on my screen.
Stickers all over the scope. Yeah. Just can't see anything. Yeah, that'd be pretty painful.
Pretty horrible, yeah. But so far, not very impressed with what Fnatic are doing. With that aggressive push coming in from Flusha, I would have expected them to have some sort of a failsafe. If he's pushing that aggressively so early on, then maybe you have one of the guys, Crims, who's normally the first guy to rotate towards inner. Maybe have him in connector so he can be there to hold Envy back just to prevent that potential opening for Envy that they took full advantage of, just going straight in as soon as they had the opportunity.
They've got a really sick situation going now, because there's another force out of Fnatic, and Fnatic are going to need to win these forces. So far, they've been coming for a little bit short in that sense, and some good damage done. Happy and Apex are basically dead at this point. Apex will fall, but meanwhile, MBK is going to just work his way through Ali. So big pressure from Fnatic, from Envious onto Fnatic.
Flush is going to take down Keo, but NBK just continuing that steady form. He's been doing really well from Ali.
This is awkward here for Fnatic. Both stuck in the same positions here. Trey comes in, comes on 4 HP. Again, though, he's against an AWPer, so it might not actually hurt too much to be on 4 HP, because if he gets shot by an AWP, doesn't really matter if he has 100 HP if he gets hit in the chest.
If he's been tagged up this heavily, then there should be someone aware of the fact that they've hit Krims quite a bit.
Kenyes is not going to risk it though. He's got the AWP and he's going to hit the shots. Very well played by Kenyes there to know exactly the angles as to, you know, how he's opening up the path for Krims to attack the site and to capitalize. 6-1 now. Fnatic can buy again. Krims' money has always been like a little bit compared to everybody else.
They're going to do it. 2 mag 7s. This time not on Flesh Out. Flesh is actually going to have a cult for inner site. I'm assuming JW is going to push aggressively somewhere, if it's Ali or if it's up towards 7 chain.
Oh, Alphonse is in right now, as well as Flesh. Look at the spray down coming in. And this play from Envious is getting kind of wiped out. But 3 players left.
But this is what I wanted to see the ramp. Flesh Out went aggressively. Here they had Olaf going aggressively with the Maxim, but they had Flesha to back him up. So there's no way Envy can actually get onto that B bomb site, so they're stuck. They've also done quite a bit of damage on the from Fnatic's part. So this is a great situation. This is what they could have done the round Flesha went aggressively up into Black Walls.
Ooh, JW, is he going to go up? Happy, oh.
How does he get a headshot?
I don't know. He's directly below him.
He's curving, and Kenny just wipes out Apex. Is it a nice shot, by all means, but not where you want to go. Still, they do have 6 rounds. They have a lot of money to shed. So, it's not the end of the world. Keo's actually going to buy an off for Kenny. I think. No. No, he actually, my bad. Kenny bought himself. Self-sufficient, man.
So Krim's getting all the frags for the team as well.
Yeah.
For Fnatic. He's got like 12 or something. Pranex and JW on like 1 and 2. So Krims is again today a bit beast mode for his team. Nice trade coming in from Envious though on the yard area. Olafmice is working the AWP and connector to take down 2 players. Well done. And now it's Happy who's left alive. 1 versus 3. And he's going to get caught here by multiple players. And honestly, this is a hopeless situation on such low HP. Oh, what damage can he do? He gets 2 quick headshots. That is fantastic damage to be finished off by JW's HE in the end. But that's fantastic damage. That sets Envious up a little bit to get, if they win this force buy, to cripple the economy of Fnatic and reset them. And then for them, you know, they could potentially drive home a lot of rounds in quick succession. We'll have to see if that's going to be the case, as Fnatic do have a strong buy. JW, I mean, he's been just mag 7-ing only the last couple of days, it seems like.
Yeah, he had a period like that a year and a half ago. We would just do that over and over again. And he's the kind of player that can make it work. He likes playing close up. He likes being in the face of people. We see that when he plays with the AWP as well.
I was just about to say, great characteristics for an AWPer. That makes a lot of sense.
Great characteristics if you're JW. I guess that's pretty much what. Not everyone can make that work. Well, he's just going to be sitting still in Ali, not pushing aggressively with the Mag 7 this time around. And, well, it wouldn't have mattered all that much. He would have gotten intel, but all of Envy are setting up for an inner approach here.
Yeah, here we go. Big push again. At least they should be able to get the bomb plant secured. Nice entry coming in. Apex with the frag. And Kiyoshima from that key position trying to get the shot over the top of the train into connector to eliminate these CTs as they flush out of connector. Apex is going to be doing that job though. Quick kill onto JW could make the difference here, as the rest of his teammates are also starting to get more ground and more frags, leaving just Krims left alive, but not for long. Apex comes in and he had a huge round there. 4 kills, just charging up that yard. And it's going to be a 7-3 scoreline with Fnatic reset. The force buy is going to do wonders for Envious.
Yeah. Things are just going Envious way right now. Even after losing an anti-eco, bring it right back with a force buy. Now send Fnatic to economic despair, really, with the force buy of their own. And they even managed to pick up an AWP. Apex picked up 4 kills and an AWP, so he passed that on to Kenny. And that makes Envy all the more deadly.
Oh dear. JW going down there, the only guy with a gun for his team, and the rest of his teammates are just in the yard, chilling. Except Flusher, of course, he's got the P250, and he's being covered by Kiyoshima. Xevious with a very nice movement here towards the A yard at the end. Very good cognizance of where they can be attacked from, and they will clean house without losing a single player.
Right now, MB are doing a good job. They seem to be very aware of what kind of economic state Fnatic are in, and they're playing that in a very good way. Barring that first anti-eco, they've been doing a pretty good job of it.
Hmm. And look at this buy from Fnatic. Two mags, a Famous, warp with no nades, basically. It's pretty rough.
It's really rough, and JW, he's not going to go aggressively into top. That's where I would have expected to see him, but decides not to go for that. Now he's trying to lurk his way closer to that pop dog, and this is where he should be with the Mag 7, unless he's playing on the inner bomb set like Flush is with his. But I think this is going to be heavily reliant on Crimson Olaf Meister, who has the better weaponry at this point of time.
This juncture.
Yeah, and, well, Fnatic right now, they've been allowed to get into pretty aggressive positions. Emi is expecting something weird to come out of Fnatic, some sort of an aggressive move, but it's not happening. Time is ticking down, and, well, we might see an inner push here. We see two people in black walls just looking down lower and towards higher. Bomb is actually moving back towards T main. So we might just see a very quick A execute from out into yard.
Indeed. Olaf Meister gets a kill into MBK there. It might not matter too much because still four players come out of the yard and the connector area. Yard into the yard from Popdog and teammate. Mm-hmm. But Fnatic looks like they have good angles covering these positions, and the trades are not happening here for Envious. Just Happy and Kenny's left alive, and they need to make something of this situation. They need to at least get some kills in. At least two more frags to make this round of games. Oh, God.
Flying Mag 7s is not going to help your case. Kenny, luckily, though, hadn't committed too far out, so he might be able to hold on to this weapon, but... Flush is nearby.
Uh-oh. Oh, the timing, but he'll get the
still
frag.
Still gets a headshot.
Oh, dear. That's not nice for Kenny, yes. Now, 8-4 is the score, and Fnatic, you know, they're still in a lot of trouble here because we'll get the buy coming in from Envious, so... They can still make this 8-7, but it's only really possible if they win this round, basically, and break the economy of Envious.
Yeah.
That's the only way that's happening. Otherwise, it could very well go to 11-4.
Yeah, very quickly could happen. Lots of Molotovs on Envy's side right now. A decent amount of nades on Fnatic as well. JW kind of being the only guy without anything to work with, but he's got a Mag 7 again. Not playing aggressively this time either. I'm curious as to what he wants to really accomplish. Pronix going down to Kenny. An already great start for Envy. Okay, I like this move from Fnatic. Trying to get JW into a forward position here. But again, Envy are playing this so patiently. Well, yard right now. Pretty sparsely protected if you're Fnatic. Holding down this entire yard area with two players is pretty tough.
First contacts here for Kiyoshima at the very least. And they're working down these Fnatic players. They're just down to three players now. And Envious can really pick either bomb site if they just attack with coordination. You'd expect them to have a good go of it. Great nade, though, from Flusher. That's going to just take Kiyoshima out of the picture straight away. And boom, frag after frag. All of a sudden, Envious have nothing left to show for themselves. And the bomb is quickly making its way through Popdog. This is the plan B into this A bomb site. Olaf Meister on point as always. He can see ahead. He understands the tricks at play. You'll take down Kenyasu now. Jump shots, of course. Olaf Meister, sneaky little play, and that's going to be the rest of Envy's cleaned up. That is amazing that they saved that round.
Yeah, very much needed as well. JW having a bit of a rough go at it. One kill so far to his tally, but I guess six assists. So he has contributed in some fashion, but...
yeah, exactly. It's not
great.
Game for him so far.
Yeah, but the weird part is that even though it feels like we're seeing a very underwhelming version of Fnatic, they still have five rounds, and Envy, they're forced on an eco before the last round, so this could very easily be six rounds for Fnatic, and if they can get away with that from this first half, I'd be very happy if I were the Swedes.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I was thinking exactly the same a moment ago. I was just thinking five CT rounds.
Yeah, how have they gotten there? And that's the weird thing, because it doesn't feel like Fnatic have played particularly well.
These five Deeks, though, man, they are scary, and they're looking for the B play. The two Molotovs, you can definitely know that MBK and Happy are going to be wanting to double Molotov the bomb. That's going to be the play once the bomb goes down. That's, of course, for like 14 seconds, essentially, you can kind of waste away from the bomb with just Molotovs.
So that's 14 out of 35 seconds, which also it's also going to take Fnatic a bit of time to actually get there.
Oh. Producer is pointing out that every single turn Envious is using the Legal Blaze. And here we go, the bomb is down. Can they make the play count here? The two Molotov players are still alive. I'm not sure how happy he is just now, but MBK's up there by the door. And wow, Kenny S gets himself two kills. They are wasting key time here. We know that it's the Molotov play. That's the deal here. MBK and Happy have positioned themselves for the Molotovs. There is the first one. Did that miss? I think that may have missed the bomb. They can still get up there and defuse it, in fact. So the Molotovs are not going to come into play at all here. But did they kill enough time? Oh, wow. At last Molotov will find his way onto the bomb just in the nick of time. And it's going to work. Amazing stuff there from Envious. They make that round work 9-5 now. They can very well get that 10-5 scoreline. However, Fnatic should have enough money. Nope. I thought they had a little bit more than this, but no, they don't. They are kind of screwed over at the moment on the money.
Yeah. Lost too many players. But rounds like that shouldn't work, but MBK getting that sick long-range deagle shot onto the guy on higher.
Yeah.
That really messed them up, because that also takes them, you know, that puts Fnatic in a really awkward situation where they still have to deal with the players, not only the Molotovs coming out from higher, but they also have to deal with the fact that they can also push out with those Molotovs and create more of a distraction.
And here it is, it's beginning right now. Kenny S and MBK making the frags happen. The trades will come in from JW and Crims, but Apex has found himself a nice opening into Yard, and that's going to claim the A-bomb site for Envious. They can put the French flag, stick it in the middle of that bomb site, claim those radioactive materials, but in comes Crims looking to reclaim the Yard, and he's doing a good job so far. He's pushed them back, but there is still an MBK. He's very healthy coming from Ali. He could make the difference here for Envious.
I like the decision Fnatic is making, though. They're sticking together, and I think that's kind of what they have to do. So they checked inner site, didn't find anything, and this I'm not such a big fan of. They're splitting up right now. Well, JW is going to find Kenny, and that's the bomb drop. I'm no idea what Kenny wanted to do in back alley with that bomb. But MBK, nowhere near the bomb right now. Well, he's got 30 seconds to retrieve it. So plenty of time to work with, but he's going to have to find two Fnatic members at this
point. Here we go. Should be able to get this one for free. And he's trying to kill as much time as possible before giving his position away. And there we go, gets the snap. The time, though, is a really key factor. There's another player left alive. For all MBK knows, he could be Popdog, he could be Connector. He's getting shot. Oh, what? One bullet! Amazing MBK. He'll win that round somehow for Envious. One single bullet, he was getting spammed down. He barely could work out where he's even getting shot from. But one bullet's all it takes. MBK makes it 10-5. And that 10-5 scoreline could basically be the difference.
Oh, yeah. And it could have been way more for MB as well.
Because that's a scoreline that you think, okay, this is kind of what train is like right now. 10 rounds for T-side, 5 for CT, that's kind of okay. So really, every single round there was very important for either side at that point. And, you know, MBK swings it.
Yeah, it literally swinged it. Damn. It looked like it just panicked around his mouse and just like, whoop.
I'm just going to one-shot this guy. Yeah. Everything's okay. It's fine.
It's all good. Okay, so Molotov, actually, and the pistol on Pronax, so they might want to zone out an area. I haven't used it yet, but they've got three people in alley. There's the Molotov out. That's actually going to create some space, but Kenny. Oh, God, Kenny. So sneaky. Picks up two frags onto Pronax and Crims. Still duking it out with all of Olafmeister Axe. They're going to pick him up as well. Why not? Now it's all down to Flusha. So that pistol went from being looking seemingly all right to going right down the drain.
And that's one of those things where it's like, how do we let this happen, guys? If somebody checks that position, he doesn't kill three of us, basically. Maybe he kills two of us, maybe he kills just one of us.
Yeah.
But at least he won't kill everybody.
And drop the bomb in alley and make sure we lose, pretty much. I like the idea though from Pronax, Molotoving off that edge. It forced the way to Emius members, so you know the idea is solid. You just have to clear your corners. It's the lesson of the day.
Yeah. Well, it's partially a mechanics thing as well. Like good mechanics. Some players are just like super anal when it comes to picking up all the corner clears. That's the thing. We've got the Nova shotgun coming in from Kiyoshima. Big Papa Pump is going to claim its victims. And that's a lot of money there for Envious, those shotgun kills.
More to be had, potentially here. Two remaining Fnatic members running towards Kyo. Tags of one actually gets Flusha pretty quickly and manages to escape as well. So Krims all by himself. Not too much hope of actually picking up anything at all here. He might pick up a kill, but he's not going to get a weapon, and Kenny's even going to deny him that pleasure.
That's such a classic position, that dumpster, when it's like you want to save and get like good angles to the engagements.
Mm-hmm.
So in every iteration of this map, in every game, it's just like, I remember just sitting on that dumpster for a long time getting kills. But 12-5, and Fnatic, of course, in with a save now. Envy is picking up a very clean round there. They're going to be on some rifles, two Famas, three M4s.
Yeah.
And
I like this from Kyo, though. This is a very safe choice from Kyo, from throwing away that Nova. He's already gotten paid for its usage. So just making sure that if the case happens that Fnatic force buys, and judging from their CT side, that could happen at pretty much any given point, you might as well have a Colt to deal with it.
Yeah, and here it is, the push come in. Even getting a bomb down for Fnatic at this point, they're going to buy Byron next round no matter what. Bomb down is not a big, big deal. And Tiger's happy. He's going to flash himself straight through. Just, wow. It's just going to completely maul them with these pistols, with these M4s. And that's going to be Envious with another round that looks pretty clean, unless JW can pick something up sneaky. But he was waiting for the flanker, but there was none such player. Envious comes in, and JW goes down for free. That's two rounds where Envious didn't lose a player.
Yeah, so their economy is booming right now, and that's a pretty good spot to find yourself in on the CT side. Understandably, Apex and MVK not going to even bother to upgrade, just going to get full nades. And well, we're going to have to see something big coming out of Fnatic right now. JW picking up the AWP. Had a similar spell on Inferno as well yesterday, where we didn't see him use the AWP a single time on the CT side of Inferno. But as soon as he had the opportunity on the T side, he started doing work with it. And Fnatic desperately needs him to find some openings for them.
Yeah, here goes Fnatic. This round incredibly important for them, as are all of them at this point. With Envy so close to the W. They need to win this clean, though, if they possibly can find a way to do so. And looking for the picks to begin with. Very defensive, though, from Fnatic, actually. They're trying to hopefully capitalize on any aggressions from Envious, but Envious realize that they don't need to take risks right now.
Yeah, no reason for them to chance it. And we talked about this yesterday. If you're starting off the game, no need to deviate from your default before you get a good feel of what your opponent is doing. That's when you can start adapting away from your default and changing up things. But as of right now, they just play it as safely as possible and wait for Fnatic to make their move.
Train is a good map for it as well, and Fnatic will make their move. Pranax will go through the smoke. He was just going to completely wreck Kiyoshima, removing him from that forward position and giving the rest of the Fnatic players an opening towards this A yard, and it's actually happening right now. Ali's opened up as well. The aggression from Fnatic really truly begins. 20 seconds to plant the bomb though, so this could be a very big issue because we're having Apex holding it down. He just turns the corner around the train, takes down Olafmeister as well, and all of a sudden Krims and JW need to do a lot of work. There is less than 10 seconds to plant the bomb. The bomb is going to be going down at this point, and they will somehow get that bomb planted in the chaos. I don't know how they've done it, but here we go. Retake situation for Envious. Happy picking off Krims. JW now has to clutch. He hasn't had a great performance in this train game thus far, but hopefully this can be the moment for him to finally shine. We'll get the defuse attempt in, and Happy will take him down with the wide peek. Envious will save the rounds, and yep, he's good. Okay, so Envious will save the rounds.
Yeah.
They lose four players, but they had such clean rounds previously that they're going to be they've been passed.
Perfectly fine. In Fnatic's case, they do get the bomb plant, so that's going to give them the opportunity to actually get a pretty good buy-in with that money loss bonus. No ops though for Fnatic to use this round. Not that it has had the biggest impact really on any sides. We had a couple of rounds from Olafmeister with that up on the CT side, but other than that, it's been mainly rifles, but that's also partly because Fnatic have had a pretty terrible economy the entire game. Right now, Fnatic just slowly setting up for, waiting for any sort of aggression coming out from Envy, but I don't see Envy doing too much differently from that previous round. Worked out nicely enough for them, playing it defensively, taking the duels when Fnatic members ran to them.
And we've got double AWP coming from Happy and Kenny. Yes, that is a scary prospect to run into. And Fnatic likely looking at a fast play. And if they have the smoke execute, that would be perfect for a round like this. With all those AWPs in play for Envious. Mm. However, they've got to make sure they don't get thinned out before the push actually happens. And Kenny is looking towards Ali. Nice passive play here from Envious. They're not sure if there is a T in the yard at the moment because of the smokes that have been down. Look at this very heavily reactive play from Envious. And now the push comes in from Fnatic. They're moving into the A-bomb site. Pronex gets the entry. Olaf Meister with one of his own as well. Down to three now, Envious. They need a big, big response at this point to save this round. But it looks like Fnatic all over this. A very patient round. Pronax is going absolutely mental with three kills. MBK is now alive against the rest of the team, the Fnatic side. And no more damage is to be sustained by Fnatic. They will pick up a round. But how can they keep it going? Can they keep the ball rolling?
Yeah, that's a big question. Still, Envy's economy, not too affected. Kenny is the one who's going to have to fall down to a pistol for this round. But other than that, pretty decent buy all over. And actually, what am I saying? Obviously, he's going to have the money for an op. But yeah, full buy pretty much for Envy's side. They're not too fazed by losing that round. And the problem for Fnatic now is if they lose this one, they're right back to where they started. And at that point, Envy has map point as well. So you couldn't dig yourself a deeper hole than Fnatic potentially could find themselves in. The same setup as last round, though. So patiently waiting, expecting Envy to push aggressively somewhere. But again, Envy just playing it passively. And I wouldn't be too surprised if we saw a very similar execute from Fnatic again. Having Crims throw the pop flash over into Yard and having three main players explode out alongside that six train while Olaf Meister works as a bit of a decoy and kind of a lurker for Fnatic and Ali.
Do we see much of an adjustment here though for Envious? They are playing a little bit more forward into the yard. So that
yeah,
is,
right now
that's
they're moving forward.
It's a bit of a variation.
They could be sensing that Fnatic might set up for the same type of play they did in the previous round and that's why they want to play forward.
Yeah, Apex actually pop flashed himself into Pop Dog there and he didn't see much.
They're trying to go position here though.
Again, like he's gonna get pop flash into team main this time. They're really antsy to find out what's going on, and they're gonna get two kills out of it. And the bomb is down there in team main as well. This is a massive disaster for Fnatic. The round that they had in plan in store. I mean, there's 15 seconds left. They don't have time to get the bomb and onto that bomb site. They picked it up, but Envious are just laying into them with the rifles, and this is horrendous for the Swedes. Happy will clean up the rest of them, and you can see why Apex is getting pop flashed in there because Envious are like. Okay, God, really?
There's like
40 seconds left, you're not pushing? And it's like, okay, he sees nothing. It's like, okay, yeah. Pop flash, team main, 30 seconds left. Really? There's nobody here? Really? What's
going on?
And the bomb is down here. What is happening right now? And they hit, I mean, that is ridiculous. 15-6 now.
Yeah, and well, that horrible pit that we're talking about for Fnatic is where they find themselves. One AK to work with.
Oh, dear.
Do have two deagles, though, so might see some long-range magic from either Olaf Meister or Flesha, but it's looking pretty dire. They're not short on nades, though. I guess that's the one positive thing you can pull out of this round. They do have the potential to either go for smoke execute outside, or they can go towards inner, smoking off all of the lanes and get a bomb plant down. But at this point, it doesn't really matter if you get a bomb plant as long as you don't win the round, because it's going to be over.
Yeah, these pistols, man. I don't know about these. You can see Envious playing very far back in the yard, able to anticipate how they can play their advantages against the weaknesses of Fnatic, being on those pistols, of course. And JW's just going to go in. Finds his way to E-Box, throwing away for his team. Nice takedown of Apex, but he's dinked. Down to 5 HP. Might see some nades sailing in here to finish him off. But the push, meanwhile, will go on in the B-bomb site as JW causes distraction, but Kiyoshima will hold on, and MBK, in all the distraction, has not been spotted because there has been so much in the way of distractions caused by his teammates, and he can even go for the knife. Aww. He's not going to do it. He's going to finish it clean. 16-6, and Envious once again have a very strong result against Fnatic on this map. And you can't say this time that Fnatic got super screwed because they managed to win their force by back into it. It was very back and forth at the start. They managed to get five CT rounds. It was just they just couldn't convert on the second half.
Yeah, no, I actually think they were lucky to get five rounds on their CT side, and definitely could have been more for Envious as well. On their T side, They had luck with, well, after what was a really long setup time, they had luck with the sudden aggression onto Yard.
Yeah.
That was mainly due to Pronax picking up so many kills. So I wouldn't say that's a reliable way for Fnatic to go about it from now on. And I'm surprised that we're seeing Olafmeister being put in Ally as kind of a lurker in those situations. Obviously, it's going to be the second pressure point for Fnatic when they execute towards Yard, but I would have imagined that it's more efficient to have Olaf in the middle of the heap, pretty much. So just have him in the midst of the battle at any given time because he's such a good player. Now you're kind of relying on the rest of your team opening things up for you so Olaf gets the space to actually come from behind and then come into action. So that's a bit surprising to me. I'm not really sure if that's something we're going to see at the Major or not, but so far from the two games we've seen yesterday and today, their train definitely needs a lot of work.
Well, we'll have to see how that develops in the future. Next match will be TSM against Virtus Pro and Overpass. It should be an absolutely amazing game, smashing game. So guys, stay tuned. We'll be back with that after the break.